Good morning, girls. It's Friday.
Back to spells and enchantments, potions and friends.
To Gryffindor,
Ravenclaw,
Slytherin.
Back to the place where our story begins at Hogwarts. Hogwarts.
I'm sorry. What's its name?
Hogwarts. Hogwarts.
I didn't hear you, pig.
Hogwarts. Hogwarts.
Man, I'm glad I'm back.
How do I even begin to explain what Harry Potter means to me? Harry Potter has brought me together with the most amazing people in my life. The premiere of Deathly Hallows Part 2 was one of the best nights of my life. I remember me and my friend Paisley got together before we went, and we got all dressed up together. She was Luna and I dressed like this. And we went to a park and we took pictures and ate red vines before it was time to go to the theater. And I remember we got to the theater and met up with our other friends, and it was just the most magical night. Everyone was dressed up and everyone had baked Harry Potter treats, and it's just something so crazy to be in a room with so many people who share the same passions and the same dedication that you do to this one thing, this one book. And we all just sat around and we sang Getting Back to Hogwarts and like the mysterious ticking noise and all those songs from a Harry Potter musical. I remember a bunch of us convincing the guy who was pushing the snack cart around to yell out anything from the trolley as he was going by, and I think we considerably spiked his sales, personally. And once the movie ended, I just remember like six of the people I was with sitting in the theater in our seats just bawling our eyes out as the credits rolled. And when we left the theater, there were just groups of people everywhere. People were crying and consoling each other, and we were crying. It was the scariest thought to believe that Harry Potter was over. This thing that we had all grown up with and clearly loved more than like anything else in literature. But you know what? A year has passed, and how I feel about Harry Potter hasn't changed one bit. If it has, it's gotten more intense. We, the Harry Potter fans of this world, will never let this phenomena die. Let's just look at this. This wand was made by my English teacher in grade 12. She gave it to me after a performance where I used it. This broom was given to me by my parents for Christmas last year. This scarf, knitted by Nia for my Secret Santa gift. This whole outfit I wore to the premiere of Deathly Hallows. And I've worn it at Halloween this year, where me and like five other people dressed up as Harry Potter characters and ran around campus taking pictures. And also at my friend Serena's 18th birthday party, which was Harry Potter themed. With so many passionate and dedicated people in this world, these books will never die. And all of us are going to pass these books on to our children, just like Nia said on Wednesday. Like, the day I'm looking forward to the most is the day I can hand this book to my children, or the day I can sit on the end of his or her bed and read it to them for the first time. I can't wait to see my children relive the experiences I felt reading those books. Harry Potter's affected too many people in the world for it to just up and leave. So don't believe for a second that this magical, enchanted world that we've all learned to love is going to leave us anytime soon. As J.K. Rowling herself has said, Hogwarts will always be there to welcome you home. Knox.